Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Today being the last day of Ramadan series, let's recall what we've learned in the last 29 days. So, let's see. We learned some common and important Islamic laws in the first 10 days. And the next 8 days were the noble cases of the prophets from the Quran. And the following 12 days till today, we've been learning about our 12 A'imma alayhimus salam. So today's video, as is obvious, is about Imam al-Asr, the Imam over time, our 12th Imam, Imam al-Mahdi, ajjalallahu ta'ala farajahu sharif. The son of our 11th Imam, Imam al-Hasan Askari, alayhi salam. Imam al-Mahdi is the redeemer of the world, who will appear and rule for some years before Yawm al-Qiyamah, the Day of Judgment, and redemption of justice in this world. It is said that during Imam Hassan al-Askari's funeral, his brother Ja'far stood in front of the people to lead the prayers. Before he could commence the prayer, a 5-year-old boy came out of the house and went near his uncle, shook his mantle and told him, "Set aside, uncle, only an imam can lead the funeral prayer of an imam." His uncle Ja'far stepped aside, and this 5-year-old imam led the prayers. He was our 12th imam, Imam al-Mahdi, ajjalallahu ta'ala farajahu sharif. Immediately after the end of the prayers, he went inside his house and was not seen by his pursuers and has been an occultation since then. He's called al-Mahdi, which translates to the guided one. Because the greatest prophet, Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, had declared his appearance as, "Even if a single day remains for the day of judgment, Allah will send a man from my Ahlul Bayt. He will fill the earth with justice, just as it was filled with tyranny." Thus, he's the guided one of the Ahlul Bayt alayhimu salam, who will be our savior and guide us as sahib al-zaman, the master of the era. Not only the greatest prophet, but all the 11 imams have mentioned the arrival of the Lord of the Age, such as the first Imam, Amir al-Mu'mineen, Ali ibn Abi Talib, has said, "He will direct desires towards the path of guidance, while people will have turned guidance towards desires. And he will turn their views to the direction of the Quran, while the people will have turned the Quran to their views." This proves on what words of destruction this world will be, when it will need someone to save us from evil forces, and that's when the Imam al-Mahdi will come to our rescue. And this is undeniable, that the time of reappearance of Imam al-Mahdi will be the greatest test upon the mankind. As the 7th Imam, Imam al-Kadhim alayhi salam, said, "My son, when the 5th descendant of the 7th of the Imam is not visible to you, it is when Allah will test your belief. Al-Ghayba is inevitable for the master of this affair, till the time when the religion is completely transformed and only a few people will have believed in him. My son, that Ghayba is a trial through which Allah the Almighty tests his servants. Allah the Most High has blessed the Imam of the time with innumerable noble traits and distinctive characteristics. This shows the special position held by Imam alayhi salam near Allah the Almighty." It's not even possible to discuss all these attributes, but let's see some of them. The greatest prophet, Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, has said, "The Qayyim, which refers to the one who rises, is from my progeny. His name is my name. His technium is my technium. His appearance is like my appearance. His behavior is like my behavior. He will establish among the people my practice and my namaz, and it will call them towards the book of his Lord, the High and the Mighty. One who obeys him has obeyed me, and the one who denies his ghaibah has denied me." As per a third Imam, Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam, "The Mahdi, ajjalallahu ta'ala farajahu sharif, can be known with his solemnity and his knowledge of halal and haram, as well as people's needing him and him not needing anyone." And Imam Ali al-Radha alayhi salam, the 8th Imam, has characterized the Mahdi alayhi salam as the wisest, the most knowledgeable, the most pious, and the most patient, the most generous, and the greatest worshipper of the time. Well, throughout history, various individuals have claimed to be or were proclaimed to be the Mahdi. So one may ask the ways the real Mahdi can be identified. Is there any way to recognize him? Well, yes. Unique signs were manifest at the time of Imam's birth, and such will also be seen at the time of Imam's reappearance. And about the verse 53 from Surah Fussilat of the Holy Quran, "Soon will manifest our signs in the world and in themselves, so that it is clear for them that This is the truth. Imam Sadiq alayhi salam explains that this verse is regarding the reappearance of Imam al-Mahdi ajjalallahu ta'ala farajahu sharif. Up to 400 signs of his reappearance have been narrated. It must be borne in the mind that the reappearance of Imam al-Mahdi ajjalallahu ta'ala farajahu sharif does not depend on the manifestation of the signs, but only and only upon Allah's will. Then it is possible that Allah may order for the reappearance while the signs have not been manifested. There are many traditions from our imams that prove the arrival of Imam al-Mahdi ajjalallahu ta'ala farajahu sharif from the Quran. For example, the verses that emphasis on the necessity of existence of an imam. Based on Quranic verses, Allah has chosen for every people an imam to guide them, such as verse 7 of Surah Ar-Ra'ad. And there is a guide for every people about which Imam Baqir alayhi salam is reported to have said, in every generation there's a guide from us who guides them to what the Holy Prophet Hadhrat Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam has brought. There have also been warnings about various happenings in this world that will signal the advent of the Mahdi. It will be the time of violence, tyranny, injustice, oppression, and destruction. When chaos will take over the earth, man will be his own enemy. He will defeat humanity and lose faith. And there will be a desperate need of redemption. It is said that the vast majority of people who claim to be Muslims will only prevail in name despite their practice of Islamic rites. And it will be they who will not accept Imam al-Mahdi. One third of the world's population will die from violence and the other third from the disease. There'll be dark clouds of death, distress, calamity, and fear. And thus, then shall we get the one last ray of hope, our Savior, Imam al-Mahdi ajjalallahu ta'ala farajahu sharif. As the Holy Quran says, verily with every difficulty there is a relief. So after knowing all this, as a human, what are our responsibilities towards our Redeemer? Well, the first and foremost thing to do is to believe in his return and trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he's indeed the most merciful. We'll send him to revive us from all the troubles. And once we bring the steadfastness in our faith, the next thing to do is to wait and pray for the reappearance of Mahdi al-Ma'ud, the promised one. And this demands the clarity of our heart, mind, and soul. It's only possible if we purify our thoughts and become better Muslims and the best version of ourselves. And how do we do that now? Well, we've been learning a new thing every day throughout this holy month of Ramadan. Whether it be the Islamic laws, or the stories of the noble prophets from the Quran, or the teachings of Ahlul Bayt alayhimus salam from the lives of 12 Imams. Every lesson plays a significant role in making us better humans and thus better Muslims. Listening to someone who tells you facts or narrates stories isn't the only thing that will help. What really matters is what we actually learn and how to apply these teachings of Islam in our personal day-to-day lives. And I hope I was able to bring at least a few positive changes in your lives. Last but not the least, before wrapping up this last video, I would like to thank every single one of you who supported me share my videos and helped me achieve my aim to spread the message of Islam even more. With that being said, let's pray for the early appearance of Imam al-Mahdi ajjalallahu ta'ala farajahu sharif. May Allah hasten his reappearance, inshallah. So I will see you all next year with Ramadan season 3. Until then, wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin.